Hello students, I am Professor Neeta Phulchand Gaikwad. Welcome in our free education channel English Master. Dear students, welcome back. Today is the fifth day of our Learn English in 10 Days series. So earlier I have taught and uploaded the first day, second day, third and fourth day lectures. So please check the link below in the description box. Go through the all lectures so you will aware about the thing that what we have learned in the previous lectures. Let's start for today, the fifth day, what we are going to learn. Let's check. But before starting the lecture, I really appreciate your love and support to our English Master channel. Keep supporting, do like, share, subscribe. Students, so as we started that the parts of speech, this is the most important thing to learn the English. Okay, so at the time of this is the series for the beginners. Okay, so who are not aware about anything. So students, so in the first lecture on the first day, I taught you what is noun and the types of the nouns. On the second day, we learned that pronoun and the types of pronoun. On the third day, we learned about the verb and types of verb. And actually the fourth day lecture is also uploaded. So today is the fifth day and we are going to learn adjective and the types of adjectives. Then later on, we will going to learn in the upcoming lectures that what is adverb, types of adverbs, preposition, conjunction and interjections. These are the most important parts of speech. Okay, so let's start today's session. What is adjective? What is adjective, students? The definition of the adjective is, an adjective is a describing word. It tells you more about a noun. An adjective usually appears before the noun it describes. Sometimes, though, the adjective appears after noun later in the sentence. So the basic thing is what? That it tells you more about a noun. Which word? The word which tells you more about a noun, that word we called as an adjective in the sentence. Let's learn through the examples. Look at here. A smart dog. Okay, so here the dog is a noun, but smart, this word is showing the quality of the dog. Okay, so smart is the adjective in this sentence. Smart is the adjective in the sentence. In the next picture, we are seeing that an old building. Okay, building is a noun, but old is describing the noun. So old is the adjective in this sentence. Let's learn. A deep sea. Sea is the noun, but a noun is describing by this word deep. So deep is the adjective here. And in the second picture, you are seeing watching a busy street. Okay, so here street is the noun, but it is described by a word which is busy. So here busy is the adjective which is showing something about the noun. Okay, so the words which are showing something or which are describing something about the noun, so we call them as an adjective. Let's learn the types of adjective, students. The first type we are going to learn, that is adjectives of quality. Okay, then the second one is adjectives of number. Third one is adjectives of quantity. Fourth is the demonstrative adjectives. Fifth is interrogative adjectives. And in the sixth, we are going to learn forms of adjectives that are positive, comparative and superlative. Let's start. Adjectives of quality. This is the first type. So in this type, students, some adjectives describe the qualities of noun. The adjectives that are used to describe the nature of a subject or a noun or showing the kind or quality of nouns or pronouns are called adjectives of quality. This is the definition, but let's learn through the examples so you will get the detail about idea about it. Look at this picture. A cold drink. So cold is showing the quality about the noun. Drink is the noun over here. So cold means what? This is the quality of this drink. So this is the adjective of quality. In the second one, a loud crash. How a crash is it? That is a loud crash. So loud is the quality of the this noun. So this is the adjective of quality. In the third image, you'll see that an ugly monster. Ugly is the क्वालिटी, ओके, ब्यूटीफुल, अगली, दीज आर टू क्वालिटीज. सो अगली इज द एडजेक्टिव ऑफ क्वालिटी विच इज डिस्क्राइबिंग द नाउन. सो नाउन इन द सेंटेंस इज मॉन्स्टर. हॉट बर्न, हॉट इज द क्वालिटी ऑफ द नाउन. सो हियर इट इज द एडजेक्टिव ऑफ क्वालिटी. So let's learn some more examples. A beautiful rainbow. So here in the sentences, I have just described some things like these are some words which I have highlighted. That is a beautiful rainbow. Okay, so beautiful is the quality of the noun. Beautiful is the adjective of quality which is describing the noun. Noun over here is rainbow. So a beautiful rainbow. Beautiful is the adjective of quality. A clever monkey. Clever is the adjective here. A difficult question. Difficult is the adjective in this sentence. Happy children. Happy is the adjective. A kind lady. Kind is the adjective. A new car. So new is the adjective over here. An old house. Old is describing the noun. So old is the quality. Old is showing the quality. So it is an adjective of quality. And a pretty girl. Pretty is the adjective. A rich family. Rich is the adjective. A sad story. Sad is the adjective. A strong man. Strong is the adjective. And a wicked queen. Wicked is the adjective. So students, beautiful, clever, difficult, happy, kind, new, old, pretty, rich, sad, strong, weak. So these words are showing the quality of the noun or the subject. So these adjectives are called the adjectives of quality in the sentences. I hope this thing is very much clear to you. So let's learn the next type, that is the adjectives of number. So while learning this word number, so you will get the idea that is the adjectives of number are the adjectives that are used to depict either the number of nouns or their position or place in a certain order. Let's learn through the examples that there are three types of adjectives of number, such as the first one is cardinal adjective, the second one is ordinal number adjective, and the third one is multiplicative number of adjective. So in the cardinal, while making the sentences, we are using that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I have one pen. She has two daughters. They have three children. Okay. I want four flowers. So that is the very much a good building over here, which has five floors. And number six, that is they had six different kinds of colors. Okay, so like this numbers which is showing the number, right? 1, 2 numerical number. So this is the cardinal adjective of number over here, adjective of numbers. So there are three types of adjective of numbers, such as first one is cardinal, second one is ordinal. In the ordinal form, look at here, first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, it is showing the place of the particular person, noun or subject. So this is the ordinal adjective of number. What is the multiplicative? This is showing the entries, that single, double, triple, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, like this, six times, eight times. So which is showing the entries, that is multiplicative adjective of number. So keep it in your mind, this thing, that in the adjective of number form, there are three types, that is cardinal, ordinal and multiplicative. Okay guys, so let's learn next adjectives of quantity. What is adjectives of quantity, students? An adjective used to talk about the quantity of things is known as adjective of quantity. And adjectives tell you something about the quantity. Let's learn through the examples without giving you the exact number. So those words or those adjectives that tells you something about quantity without giving you the exact number, those adjectives are the adjectives of quantity. Let's check. Like here, some soldiers. Some is not giving the exact number, so it is giving the idea about the soldiers. So some is the adjective of quantity over here. A few cups. A few is the adjective of quantity. then a lot of books, a lot of books. So here a lot of is the adjective of quantity. In this picture, a few puppies, a few is describing the adjective of quantity, which is not showing the exact number but giving the idea about the numbers. Okay, so let's learn some more examples about the adjective of quantity, that is a little ice cream. So here is a little is the adjective of quantity, which is not showing the exact number but giving the idea about the number. A little ice cream, a little is the adjective of quantity over here. Not many people, so many. Too much salt, here the much. Lots of insects, so lots of, this word. Plenty of money, here the plenty of. Some food, here the word some. And is there any milk, so any is the word. So these words which I have highlighted, that is a little, many, much, lots of, plenty of, some and any. These words are the adjective of quantity in this sentences. So keep it in your mind, those words or those adjectives which are not giving the exact number, we call them as adjective of quantity. And which words or which words are giving the exact number of the adjectives, so those you can call them as a adjectives of number. So this is the difference between adjectives of numbers and adjectives of quantity. Okay, so let's learn the next one, that is demonstrative adjectives. Earlier in the session, in the pronoun session, okay, pronoun and types of pronoun, I taught you what is the demonstrative words over there, that demonstrative adjectives are the same as the demonstrative pronouns. They are used as adjectives when they describe noun or pronoun. Those words are this. In the singular form, you can use this and that to showing the things which are nearby, which are in front of you or which you have at your place. Okay. And in the plural form, where, at what time we are using the plural forms? So this, the plural form of this is these. And the plural form of that is those. Let's learn. This book is interesting. So here, book is the noun. Okay, book is the noun. But this is the demonstrative adjective. It's giving the idea about the book. Like, so this is the demonstrative adjective in this sentence. Then, that is my bike. So your bike is standing at some, your bike is not at your place. You have parked in the parking area. So you can say that is my bike. So here in the sentence, bike, okay, my bike is the central idea, that you are showing your bike. So that is showing the demonstrative adjective in this sentence. In the number three, okay, this is the third sentence. These flowers are fresh. This is showing the plural form. Okay, this is the plural form of this. So this is the demonstrative adjective in this sentence. Then those fruits are very yummy. So it is describing the subject or the noun. So fruit is the subject in this sentence. But those is the what we say, demonstrative adjective in this sentence. Okay. So let's learn, students, what is the next, that is interrogative adjectives. As we learned earlier, that is interrogative adjectives are the words that are used to modify the noun in an interrogative form. So what are the words? Important words are, let's check this first question. Whose pen is this? If you are asking any question, whose pen is this? So whose is the interrogative adjective in this sentence. In the second sentence, this is a question, that which way did he go, which is the interrogative adjective. What subjects do you learn? What is the interrogative adjective? Which book is yours? Which is the interrogative adjective? What time it is now? What is the interrogative adjective? And students, so let's learn what is next, that is forms of adjectives. This is the most very very most important part, that is there are three forms of the adjectives, are positive form, comparative form and superlative form. So these are the forms of the particular verb. So let's learn, when you compare two people or things, use the comparative form of the adjective while the comparison. Okay, lots of comparative adjectives end in er. So most of the verbs which are ended with er, so those forms are the comparative adjectives. Okay, use the superlative form of an adjective to compare three or more nouns. Lots of superlative ends in est. So keep it in your mind, in the comparative form you'll see er at the end of the verb, and in the superlative form you will see est at the end of the verb. So let's learn through the examples. This is the small insect, but this is the smaller. Small is your positive adjective, so we can say in English grammar degree. Okay, so as you say, this is the positive degree. Small is the positive degree and smaller is the comparative degree of the verb small, because here keep it in your mind, as I taught you that er is comes with this verb, so smaller. So this is the comparative form. Okay, so look at this picture. Bright, brighter. Bright is the positive form and brighter is the comparative form. Look at here. So I'll tell you the positive degree, comparative degree, and this is the superlative form. So in the positive, the verb remains same, that dark means dark, but here er is comes with this verb, so we called as the comparative form of this dark. And in the third word, it is showing est. So as I taught you that in the superlative form, the verb is ends with the est. So this is the positive adjective form. This is the comparative adjective form. This is the superlative adjective form. Thick, thicker, thickest, like this only. There are so many words over here. Let's learn clean, cleaner, cleanest. You have to know what are the forms of the verb. What are the adjective form of the positive adjective, that is the comparative one is comes with the er at the end and superlative comes with the est at the end. Easy, easier, easiest. Fat, fatter, fattest. Flat, flatter, flattest. Heavy, heavier, heaviest. Hot, hotter, hottest. Narrow, narrower, narrowest. Noisy, noisier, noisiest. Simple, simpler, simplest. Thin, thinner, thinnest. Wet, wetter, wettest. So these are some forms of the positive, comparative and superlative adjectives. So next one, that is the with some adjectives. Keep it in your mind, with some adjective you use more to make the comparative form and most to make the superlative form. Like in the beautiful. Okay, beautiful is the form as the positive adjective. Okay, this is the adjective form, but when it ends with the f-u-l, you cannot change with the er. Beautifuler, this is the wrong formation. Okay, so you need to use more beautiful to describe the comparative form and most beautiful to describe the superlative form. So look at here, beautiful, more beautiful and most beautiful. Let's learn some words like this, that is active. So you'll not make it as active or activist. Okay, that is wrong. So you can use actives, more active and most active. More active is the comparative form and most active is the superlative form. Charming, charming is in the positive form. More charming is in a comparative form. Most charming is in a superlative form. Cheerful, cheerful's comparative form is more cheerful and positive form is most cheerful. Comfortable, like that, more comfortable, most comfortable. Delicious, more delicious, most delicious. Okay students, look at here, the comparative and superlative forms of some adjectives are completely different words, like good, better, best. The positive form of the adjective good is the good only. The comparative form of this adjective is better and the superlative form of this adjective is best. Good, better, best. So like this, here are some more words like bad, worse, worst. Bad's comparative form is worse and superlative form is worst. Few's comparative form is less and superlative form is least. Many, for this word the comparative form is more and the superlative form is most. For much, the comparative form is more and the superlative form is most. So I hope students, in this fifth day, today is the fifth day of this series Learn English in 10 Days, and you're getting all the details very clearly from my end. I am just trying my level best to teach you and I am giving my 100% that you will guys learn the basic English knowledge in 10 days, and this is my guarantee. Please go through all the lectures, check the link below in the description box. Let me know your opinion about our sessions. And yesterday I post one post on our YouTube channel, so I got very much positive response from all the students. So thanks for that. Keep supporting, do like, share, subscribe our channel, and I really appreciate from my bottom of heart that thank you so much. And do like, share, subscribe our channel. Let me know your opinion, your thoughts about this session Learn English in 10 Days, and I'm really very happy to show your response to our all lectures. So keep your response like this only. Do like, share, subscribe. Keep your blessings on our English Master channel and take care of yourself, family and friends, and follow all the rules and guidelines which are issued by the WHO, because this is the COVID-19 situation. We need to take care of ourselves and our family friends also. So do follow all the rules and guidelines. We will meet in the next session tomorrow on the day 6. So till then, keep watching. Thank you so much. Take care and bye-bye.